Anyone here who has a problem with Hindi? No, right? Okay, good. You won't understand much Hindi? Okay. All right, so I'll keep that in mind. So, okay, I'm Smita Mishra, and I'm the founder for Pool Wallet. It's a P2P, person-to-person payment app. And what we are here for is discussing a quick case study of what we did, how we started, where we realized that we are not doing so well. I wouldn't really call it a failure, but yes, we were not doing as well. And then how we pivoted and why we pivoted and how we, what were the results of it, right? And frankly, I didn't really invest a lot of time in making big slides because this is more of experience sharing. I would like to hear from you and I would like to share my thoughts. So I would say it's better if we have quick conversations and not focus much on the slides. Okay. So let me start with, who all here are entrepreneurs or planning to be one soon? Okay. How many of you build apps? You build apps? Okay. How many of you have stayed here in this room for last three sessions? You might as well just not hear anything I say, because most of what I'm going to talk right now has already been covered in bits and pieces in different classes, sessions before this. But yes, I have something very specific to talk about Pool Wallet, which would be of, I am hoping, of some help to you. Considering that only, I think I saw only one hand go up for building apps. Okay, we build apps. Pool Wallet was an app that we built. And we consider ourselves as very smart people because I've been into IT industry for 14 years. So I'm like, I know everything about the apps and I know how to build apps and what are the steps for it. I've read it. I have practiced it. I have, in my eyes, I have actually, I'm an authority on it, right? So that's where I thought I felt very comfortable going ahead with Pool Wallet just as in the way it appeared to my mind. So that's where we just started. And these are four steps that we took to build the app, which are very, I wouldn't say standard, but really, they are a progressive way of building an app. You first narrow down, you define your product, what your product is going to do. You define your personas, who are the kind of people who are going to use it. What are your storyboards, which are the use cases for which they are going to be used. Identify your target users and keep it narrow. Narrow in the sense, do not have a wide variety of users that says, Indian woman of 35 years. That's like a, that's really wide. That's not something that you can specify. I mean, it's, you can specifically think of a person like that, but you still cannot, there are so many aspects of that person, which is like, is she working? Is she married? Is she a school going? Is she uneducated? Is she literate enough to handle her working? So we have to keep it narrow. Then build your MVP. We've spoken about MVP, right? A whole lot. This morning, I think in Tim or Timothy, Arvind's class session, who was from Intuit, he was showing us a burnt pizza, right? That was a minimum viable pizza for him. But that wasn't something that his customer could have experienced. There's a burnt pizza, and you're trying to validate your idea of building the cheapest pizza, and you realize that you've failed, but the fact is you failed before your customer could even experience your service, your product. So you've not really validated your idea. So your idea, when you're developing your product, it should be minimum experience product where your customer can have some minimum experience with your product, some meaningful experience, and then decide whether he needs he needs less. So that's MVP. Iterate fast, speed is king. So we followed all of this. We tried to build up our features as fast as we could, and we kind of understood that if we do not do that quickly, we're going to be out of market. People who are going to download us today are not going to download us tomorrow if they don't find us useful, and if they're not going to keep us on their devices anymore. Use tools and analytics. Anyone here? I know a lot of tools we discussed. Any analytics tools that we have used? So anyone who has used in for any activity? Google Analytics. Anything else besides Google Analytics that you use to analyze your traffic or anything like this on your app? Sorry? Localytics. Anyone here who has heard Heap? Heap is another startup, does analytics. It's from the Bay Area. But the good part about Heap is, like in Google Analytics, you have to actually paste the code in every page that you need to track. Heap is once you, and what happens is you may have pasted it on 20 pages. What if you just forgot to do it on 2-3 and you didn't think they were important? And after you do on the all the analysis, now you need some data. So Heap is the good product which will actually help you there. They'll take all the analytics. So we did all the we implemented the right tools, we used the right analytics, we did everything that was right to the as per the book. We tested. Now there are different ways to test an app and the user experience of it at different stage. When we are strategizing the product, when we are actually executing or developing the product, and when we are actually, once we are done with the development, and then we are assessing the product. So there are different stages of a product and we test it differently. We did that also. And let me just quickly show you how we define our product. The last step is simplify, which once you've done all of this, I'll come back to simplify. But these are the two things I want to quickly share with you, how we defined our product and what are the different ways of user research methods that we applied. Can you define this? What is this? Projector, right? So we picked this, that how we define the product, like I think TV showed in his last session also, a way to define his product. It's a generally relatable tool. So when you have to actually mention about your tool, a lot of times people say Uber for food, Uber for trucks, Uber for bikes, something like that, because they're trying to refer to something which is already existing in market and then trying to say, you know what, we are doing this, which is very similar to that in that domain. So you should be able to relate your product to something, unless it's obviously out of this complete domain. That allows target users at least add two adjectives to your target users, what kind of users you're looking at, and we do the to use case to do that particular activity. So this is a projector, which is like probably a video showing tool or something like that, whatever you would like to put in there, that allows conferences and meetings people to share the same screen or be able to see the same screen together at a large number or in a larger room. You could define as you'd like. So we did this. We also understood that when we are designing our apps, we don't have to focus more on the beauty of the apps, but we have to more focus on the good user experience, which is, anyone here who's seen Reddit? Yeah? Which site is this? I'm sorry, it's small, but Amazon? Which is this? Craigslist? Yeah? How pretty are these sites? Going by the standard and technical beauty terms, these are one of the really poor ones. I wouldn't call them ugly. I mean, if I could, I would. But how popular are these? These are the leaders. These are market leaders in their own segments, everywhere they are, right? And this is what, and we understood this. As Pool Wallet, we understood this also. So we were like, we don't have to focus on how beautiful you are making it. We will make it in the best way so that the user is able to perform the activity that it is supposed to. We followed this also. We followed all the possible research methods. We went to subject matter experts, SMEs. We did one-on-one interviews. We did we tested our product as users. We tried to take it to different kind of users that we thought, real-time users, and we made them use it before us. So we did everything, though there are so many ways of user research methods, we did whatever we could apply on Pool Wallet. All right. Why did we do all of this? Because we wanted to be successful. We wanted to be an app that is used by maximum people. Adoption and use. These are the two metrics, key metrics that typically defines an app. How many are the download numbers? And how much is the actual transaction happening on that app, right? Anyone here who uses Paytm? Yeah? How often? Once in 3 months? TV, how often? 2 to 3 times a month? You also use Paytm, right? Very rare. 4 times a week? That's high. Anyway, all right. Okay. And I'll mention why we spoke about that. This is what people think about, right? TV again showed the confusion part, but I know that I have to develop this app. I know that there are people who have answered me themselves that they want this app. They would like to do something like this. So I'm on the perfect right path. I'm going to be the next unicorn. And Pool Wallet is the thing now. I'm all set to do that. And what happens actually? And yet this is a far-fetched dream that we would be still successful. But in the mid, this is all the confusion and the ups and downs that are coming up. Let's just transform this to our plan. What does it do to our development plan? What you think is you have a clear goal. You understand what you are planning to do. You understand why you're doing it. You've worked that through. You've gone through the right processes. So at the end of day, you know that it's right there. You have to just approach it. But what is the reality? There will be days nobody downloads. Then you have to figure out what happened. And then there will be days that people who have downloaded are uninstalling. So you have to figure out what's going on wrong today. Then there are days you walk into somebody and say, has anyone of you ever done a sales job? Yeah? Have you ever walked into a shop and said, here, buy this, and they've just bought it? Even B2B. Even after all the discussions have been done in the email, you can't just walk to the person and say, here it is. We don't need to talk. What we didn't probably, I wouldn't say we missed, but we should have probably talked a little bit more about what the app does before we started to send it to the users. So this is what, and look at this line that, and there's a reason why I have this particular picture. It is not mine. I've picked it from Google. But look at this graph, and here is our Pool Wallet graph. It has such striking similarity that I was like, okay, this is something true. This is actually what happens. This is the number of downloads we started, but this is after pivoting. This is after pivoting. So this is still a better diagram, better graph. Okay, so let's, after all the gyan, let's come to what Pool Wallet was. So we did all the right things. We understood how do we build apps. We went through step by step. And then we finally realized, okay, let's now come to, we were not doing what we were supposed to. We were not going there where we were thinking that we will go. Anybody who had heard Pool Wallet before he came to this conference? Okay, that was because we are connected. All right. Any other payment apps that you use? MobiQuick, wallets. Okay, so I'll come to a very, very good aspect of these wallets that we missed. So this was the everywhere. If you switch on the television, you have got Paytm, you've got Oxygen. Back then, there was this cricket team that was coming to India around September, October, and Oxygen was heavily promoting it, that bring them as guests and things like that. So we were like, sab ekdam fixed. Wallets are doing so well. We researched out, everybody's downloading wallets. There were apps which were downloaded 6,000 per day. There were 6,000 downloads per day. Such apps, we're not wrong, right? Our approach galat nahi ho sakta. We can't be this wrong. So we said, instead of a user going through X wallet, then Y wallet, because we have named here four. There are Pockets in India, Chiller, anyone else? SBI, all the banks are coming up with their own wallets. So every new day, there is a new wallet that is coming up. So what does a merchant do? If a merchant has to cater to all these users, how does it happen? He will have to technically integrate with each of the wallet to be able to use the money from there. What we did was, okay, we are going to be the pool of the wallet. We are plugin for the merchants. So this is what we thought in our mind. But when we started to, and our key metric constantly was number of downloads. For some reason, we were very hung on the downloads, number of downloads. What we sold our pool wallet as, it's a wallet of wallets. And it's like, okay, how many of us actually share? Do you go to outings with your friends and actually share your bills?
No.
Anyone here who actually shares the bill and says, okay, split amount, going Dutch? Split wise, okay. How often have you done that? Every day? Okay. All right. Now that's an interesting case. So what we were suggesting people was, we thought this is our ideal customer, right here, who splits every bill. If he goes out to eat, if he goes to movie, if he goes to gift something, he'll split the money, right? That's our ideal customer. Who are these kind of customers? We did not imagine you, Sarab. We imagined college going kids. We imagined young professionals who have just started to earn, but they don't have a married family. So their spending trend is different. And that's where we started to sell this as a app which you can actually use to pool the money together. If he has MobiKwik, you have Oxygen, you have Paytm, you all can pool in together and spend the money there. Right? That's how we started to sell. People started to ask, where do we use that? How do we, because we don't share, so where do we use it? And we started to actually tell them, okay, you could share it, you could use it for shared services, you could use it for cabs, you could use it for movies. If different kids are in different countries, you could use it to share your parents' healthcare bills. So we even went to that extent of giving them use cases. Corporate giftings. But what actually happened after all the efforts? And these are the original. After my cousin, he lives in Chhattisgarh, my cousin, he saw this app. He called me up and he said, he's elder to me. So I said, yeah, bhaiya. He said, yaar, karun kya main is app se? That means, what should I do with this app? I was like, yeah, it's for sharing, right? It's go ahead. When you're sharing amounts, just use it. He said, where is the sharing? I was like, right there, come on, create a wow. Wow is wishes and wants. So whatever you want to... And we created multiple number of YouTube videos explaining that wow. But we never thought, why not just change this wow? Take it off, because when a person looks at it, nobody looks at an app and then says, let me go to this YouTube video, learn the app, and then come back and use it. Nobody does that, right? So it should have occurred to us that let's get rid of this wow word and start with pools or something. What we did was, have a wow board where we have the discussions, and we literally made the pooling app exactly how we talk. Acha, I'll invite you guys for the sharing, and if you guys accept it, then you have to pay for it. So it became a whole lengthy process, the pooling process, the product pay, and then once you accept the payment, then it converts into a product, which is a financial product. It was such a huge lengthy process, and that was the only thing you could anyways do in the app. So if you could not understand that one aspect of the app, then God alone knows what you would do with it. Because you didn't have anything else to do in that app. You had payments, but it was so layered. It was underneath, and on top of it, there were so many things that was difficult. Okay, guys, wake up. Anybody who's sleeping. So what was the result of this? What did we do? We had some downloads. Don't look at that part of it. Just go from the first half to this half. And can you see it? We somehow pushed downloads, because when we actually started the app, we pushed for it, and a lot of people did download it, and we were happy. To start with, we were happy, but then it started to decline. We couldn't get new downloads. The downloads we got were actually getting uninstalled. So we needed to understand where are we going wrong. And that's when we moved on to our new business model. Now this business model was nothing new besides the fact that we just highlighted what we were doing anyways. We had all the wallets, we had credit card, debit card, net banking, and we highlighted that. So we just highlighted that, we added features like DTH recharge, mobile recharge. How many of you actually use any app for their mobile payments, bill payments? Which apps? Not apps, banking apps. Okay. For electricity bill? Okay. DTH recharge? But most of us may not still be using a single app for doing a lot of things, right? So we thought this was an area where we could help. Paytm obviously has that, but then Paytm expects people to have wallet, some money in the wallet to be able to spend. So we said we don't even want that. And frankly, when we actually put all of this, we realized that at the end of the day, what we are only talking about is requesting payments and making payments. We don't care if it is as a pooled one, if it is one-on-one, if it is between merchant and consumer, if it is between one business and another business. All we're talking about is requesting payments and making payments. So that's what we did. What were the results? We're actually, somebody said the hockey stick or the J curve and things. We actually saw that happening to us. Very recent, but it's there. And we're actually now happy. We are now getting busy, which is a good problem to have. Now we come to our session. This was all the background for it. All right, we started. What is pivoting? What do you think it is? And there's a lot of text here. Don't even try to read it, because if you read it and you understand this part, then you might as well just walk on, because this is the crux of pivoting. What he's saying is, and what I actually want to hear from you. Do you think pivoting is bad? Do you think it's a sign of weakness or failure? You failed and therefore pivoted. Have you ever pivoted in your life? Forget apps, forget. Okay, so we'll come to both the parts. So, you want to say something? So pivoting, as per Alan Spoon, is when your team realizes that your plan A is not working. Let's put together a plan B and let's see if that works for you. And if it doesn't, then you have to go to plan C. You have to keep iterating until and unless you get that scalable business model. And if we come to a different definition that I picked up, it's the same thing. It's a strategy for iteratively searching for a repeatable and scalable business model. What did Amazon do before? Like today it sells everything, right? What did it sell earlier? Only books, right? That's that evolution where it decided that they could actually sell something more. That's also a way of pivoting. What is Google? Google was a search engine, right? That too 12th on its rank when it started. What is it today? It's everything. It's actually everything. It's got Droid, it's got apps, it's got ecosystem, it's got everything. It's got maps. Why Chromebook is not so popular? You would have to research it on. Yeah. It's not so popular compared to. Maybe there are things that they want to pick up later. I really would not have the right answer for it right now. Yeah. Any other pivoting that you could cite that you are aware of? What pivoting is? I mean, which companies have actually pivoted? Mm-hmm. type of planes that they were making. Very nice. Anyone here Twitter? Yeah. Do you know why it has only 140 characters? Why not 120, 100, 80, 160? Why 140? SMS? Yeah. Right. Because it was originally an application for subscribing and downloading, subscribing and listening to podcasts, and then which was called audio, and then iTunes was coming in, so they knew that they would get killed. They have to pivot from there. That's where Twitter came in, and it became a communication app there within the company. Therefore, it had SMS 140 characters. And so these are Instagram. Was Bourbon, which was a gaming platform. And they had all the elements of that mafia wars and all those kind of games. And then they realized there's so much of clutter, let's cut down. So that's what we also did for, okay, coming back to the pivoting thing. So it's a strategy for iteratively searching for a repeatable and scalable business model. So we, at Pool Wallet, understood this, that we had to pivot, but where were we going wrong? We were unable to figure that out. And so we looked at the business model. This is a lean canvas for standard business model. Cite your problems. Where does an app take birth? At which stage? Where do you think that app starts? That this is where the concept of app is there. Where do we start it? What does it start with? An idea, a belief, necessity, problem to solve. I would go with that, yes. Because a lot of times what happens, great men think alike, right? So I am going to think same way that you're going to think. So we all will have great ideas, which are actually good, but where we fail is at the execution. Somebody executes the same solution so well, they are successful. And that's where, we were trying to understand what are we doing that's not so correct, and we looked at our business model. So this is a standard lean canvas where you put your three problems, features, key metrics that you want to measure on the product side. On the market side, there are a lot of market factors also, which are beyond your control. So even if I'm doing my best as Pool Wallet, there are things which suddenly Paytm comes and pumps in 600 crores. In the fintech market, every other wallet, which was otherwise doing good, is not doing good now. It's not their fault. It's not like they failed. It's just that somebody else did something which is an unfair advantage to them, given by the market, right? So we kind of analyzed ourselves on this, and then we actually, now this is where our pivoting story starts. So we had our users. I actually myself tried to understand, and I spoke to 120 of our initial users one-on-one. 120 calls, which ranged from 5 minutes to 30 minutes each. And it could be anything. Spoke to each user. Why? Because at the time that we launched Pool Wallet, we were invited by NASCOM Product Conclave to showcase there in Bangalore. We were selected for it. We were also the NASCOM Product of the Week for sometime in November. And then we keep getting a lot of attention from two different aspects. One is from the product and fintech aspect. One is from the women in tech aspect. Maybe that's because I'm the founder. So we keep getting a lot of attention from these two areas. And they want to see it grow, because a lot of investors keep talking to us. And every time the point at which we stop is traction. And we knew that traction is super important for us every day. I know that a gentleman here this morning talked about organic growth, but if you have to really scale up in the way that you can sustain in the market, and his business model was different, so I can't comment on that, but I would think that for a Pool Wallet kind of business, you need capital, you need good investment to be able to do good marketing and be able to take it forward. So we were running around investors and we got stuck at traction. That's where we did the 120 calls. What we realized was, and because of all the attention that I mentioned we were getting, I got invited to a college in Lucknow Babu Banarsi Das University, which has 10,000 students across their MBBS, engineering, MBA, dental, everything. So I was speaking there, and Rana Atheya from dogspot.in was also there speaking. He's just got funded by Tata, Mr. Ratan Tata. So we were speaking about the apps and how we should grow and things like that. I spoke to the kids there, and they were all like, yes, we share, we eat together, we go to movies together. I was like, this is the perfect platform for me. Like, 10,000 students are there. I could just get this app through them. And when I started to talk to them, they were like, yes, yes, ma'am, we will do it, we'll do it. Most of them downloaded, then nobody did anything, then a lot of them uninstalled. I was like, what happened? And so half of these 120 were actually students from that university. And what we realized was, they said things like, madam, hum share to karte hain, but aisa nahi hota ki roz ka roz hum hisab karein. It is like, what we do is, is baar tu pay kar de, agli baar main pay karunga. Types of discussion. Like, you pay it this time, we pay it next time. If we go to movies, some one person pays it this time, another person pays it next time, but it never happens that you exactly, share the amount each time. It didn't happen. So I was like, okay, so somewhere you must be sharing, right? So we came down to gifting, marriage gifting, birthday gifting, baby showers, everything. But things like that happened once in a while. And so the use case that we had was, okay, so once in 3 months, when you have to do that sharing, you will go to App Store or Play Store, download Pool Wallet, and then do the sharing. And that's unrealistic to expect of the users. Jo apps hain, wahi use nahi karte. And Paytm is there, so popular, but only one out of so many people, three out of so many people are using Paytm. So imagine of an app which just caters to one use case, which you do once in 3 months. So you'll, this rare chance that this will ever scale or succeed. That was our main point where we realized that our use case is not scalable. It's there, it's a need, but it's not a need that everybody would want to use for. So what do we do now? So we went to our next, whenever we used to explain the app to anybody, they would be more interested in everything else but the pooling part. They were like, yeah, pooling to theek hai, aur kya? Can I make payments? Can I accept payments? Can I request payments? Yes, you can. Can I plug it in as a payment gateway? Yes, you can. So a lot of traction that we got, we realized was from there. So I would like to compare this situation to anyone who's had Wrigley gums, chewing gum, Wrigley, you like it? Anyone who doesn't like it? Okay. So that guy, his name was Williams Wrigley Jr. He used to sell soap in an open market in Chicago in 1980s. And he used to give chewing gums as a free offer so that the people would buy his soap. What he realized was his chewing gums got so popular that he eventually started to sell chewing gum, and now you know where he is, rest is history. So kind of we are also trying to build that history. So we realized that everything else that we never thought was important, because we tried to put everything underneath the pooling. So pooling is the main thing, and then under it you have payments, you can be integrated with merchants, you can be used as payment gateways. Everything was there, but we never highlighted them. And when we spoke to our users, that's when we realized what were we doing wrong. Our entire, you understand anatomy? Yeah, what is the anatomy? Anatomy is the outline, the outer structure of something. So our anatomy of our research, user research, was perfect. We did everything right. It's like the anatomy of being friends and networking. It's the same. Two people come, they have coffee, they talk something, they go back. Friends also do that, networkers also do that. What is the differentiator is that the networking people talk work also in between. They go back and follow up. But just by looking at it, you can't say. They can be two friends, they can be two networkers. Similarly, everything that the user research needed, we did. We spoke to the users, we built the app stepwise, we narrowed down our target users. We did everything that was really important. What we forgot to do was ask the right questions. We asked them the question, but we asked them, do you pool? Do you share? Of course I share. Who's going to say, no, I don't share? Sarabjit shares every day, right? But it's like, I should have asked, how often do you share? or maybe we should have put a question which tells us, which actually was meaningful for the use of the app in terms of frequency, in terms of volume of transaction. We never really focused on that. We focused on the fact, do you do this? Yes, we do this. With whom? Friends, family, okay. So that's where our app design got made. So we kind of failed at the right questions there. So, okay, that's what. And then what happened after we actually started to ask the right questions, we segregated the feedbacks, and what we realized was that most of the people, like I ask you, how many people do this payment, that payment, bill payment, or electricity payment, or mobile bill payment? So what we realized was a lot of us have similar kind of expenses, similar kind of spending trend, but we spend through different ways. So we segregated those top 3-4 use cases where we realized most of us do it this way or that. And then we put them in the, we highlighted, because we already had those features. We had to highlight them and make them more, market them more so that people understood that they could use it. Home delivery is one such case, which actually gave us, has started to give us a lot of traction. So an app, imagine, a pooling app, which just has payments in it. Now we go to a home delivery guy and we say, what do you do if your customer is not at home and their son is there at home and you have to deliver food? हम बाद में आके पैसा ले लेते हैं, वो आके हमारे दुकान पे दे देते हैं. We said, okay, how about you giving a call to them and saying, I've handed out the food to your son, make the payment. And they make it payment right then using pool wallet, because they have your pool wallet ID and all they have to do is make the payment there. Yeah. Then we went to new upcoming retail house, retail shops, like women entrepreneurs who are doing a lot of work from their homes or boutiques and places like that. They can't afford to do COD, cash on delivery. They have all the e-commerce setups, so many carts. There are so many, rocket carts. There are so many template-based e-commerce sites where you can just list your products, sell them. But for COD, you have to manage your own stuff. We went to them and we said, why do you do COD? Why not do POD? Pay on delivery. Do not collect cash, but the same thing that they do not, the same amount that they can pay cash, they could pay through their net banking, credit card or debit card once they receive the delivery. You don't need a swipe machine, you don't need anything. Your pool wallet ID is there, your user can actually just pay to it, right? So that's one. And then market revisiting, wallets. Can you again raise hands? Sorry, I forgot. How many of us actually does use wallet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. When we went to markets, frankly, we got a very poor response for wallets. Multiple kind of questions. Do we have to put money? Because, and unfortunate for us, unfortunate for pool wallet, that our name, I mean, even if it is fortunate, but our name is pool wallet. So anybody who hears us, because we started as a pool of wallet, anybody who hears our name thinks we are a wallet. So they think, okay, so hame aapke bhi paisa rakhna padega. They're like, nahi, nahi rakhna padega. But what we didn't, what the wave that we wanted to ride on, that was being a wallet and collection of wallets, that actually was a, on the flip side, it was a bad decision from that perspective. Because a lot of people are still not comfortable using wallets. They don't want to use wallets. They are not digitally active. I myself don't buy a lot of things online. So I don't, I was like, yes, maybe I should not talk about that. So we actually explained our merchants again. It's called pool wallet. So you can actually use credit card, debit card, net banking. So what do any one of us here who does online shopping, what do you shop for? I mean, if it's not personal. Electronics, books, electronics, books, nobody clothes, clothes, many baby products, okay. And how do you make the payments? Sure. Okay, it said that 70% of the e-commerce of India is still COD. I don't like to believe that, but it's just said. I don't know if that data is correct or not. More digitally active, yes. Yeah, and going just to add to that point, Amazon has Amazon doesn't deliver in UP. Anybody knew that? The pilferage is so high in that state that they've stopped delivering there. They don't deliver anything there in the UP. So. Sorry? No, they don't take orders from that area. Amazon doesn't take order from that area. That includes Noida also, which is surprising. Yeah, but very specific. And in that also, I thought that at least the bigger cities of UP would be given some preference. They've absolutely blocked those PIN codes from there. Yeah, especially in electronics. Okay, another pivoting that we took was channels to reach our customers. We were earlier thinking of individuals, the college students, the young professionals, and we were actually approaching them. What we did was, we are still approaching them, we still want them to actually use us for pooling as well as payments, but we pivoted from there and we started to say that, okay, let's be merchant driven. Let's go to merchants and say, you use us. So we are now, anyone heard? No filter. There's a famous pub and bar in SDA in Delhi. So we are talking to them. We have bakeries like Rainbows and pretty popular bakeries there, which have registered with us as merchants. So what it does is, you'll go to those shops, you'll see pool wallet ID hanging in there. So all you have to do is pick your stuff, get your invoice, and wherever you're standing, you just make the payment and you show them and you move. So especially during the festival times or times when or party times or times when there is really good crowd at that place, you don't really have to wait for your billing and stuff like that. You can just do it and move on. That's catching up. That's one use case which is working very good for Pool Wallet right now. Another was e-commerce sites. So a lot of people like Bibo. Bibo is a Chandigarh-based e-commerce card. What that does is it allows you to list your products. They offer you the shopping cart, and you can, in short, have your website, e-commerce website. We are their plugin for payments. So each of their customer who makes a buy there on their any of their partners goes through our payment. So those are the kind of use cases which are coming up better for us than what we were doing earlier. Yeah, just kidding. So we actually came up with new storyboards. So when we decided to pivot, what all things we really did was user research again, do the right question, ask the right questions, figure out new storyboards, how we could use this app differently. So those are the various steps that we did here. But how is it different? Okay, we understand this, and we measured them. So we obviously showed the graph, which was a J curve, which went better. Now, I have this last question before we close this. How is pivot? We also agreed that pivot is not a bad thing, because pivoting means that you are probably not scaling up. Doesn't mean you are wrong. You just need to figure out that right thing that you can actually scale up with. So you can iterate and keep iterating. And then obviously, if not one, then maybe tomorrow, if Pool Wallet doesn't succeed with this, we will figure out some new storyboards, try to scale up with them. Would it be good for us to actually, at some point, give up and say, I don't know, yeah, this doesn't seem to be working. Let's find something else. Let's do something else. Yes? No? How many yes? Let's go ahead. How many? Depend on the context. Okay. Okay. How many are flat? No, don't do that. No point giving up. Okay. Most entrepreneurs are indeed very passionate about their dreams, about their the problem that they are solving. So when we are pivoting, we are still attached, as you said, we are still attached to the problem. But we change the solutions. We try one solution, then another. But we are trying to more or less solve the same problem. If we are trying to, it may not be exactly same, but we are trying to solve the related problem. We are actually moving towards our dream, a particular passion that we share. But at some point in time, there is a limit when how much you can pivot. When that stickiness is over, when that stickiness to that problem is over, maybe that's the time when you need to jump. Because as long as you are sticking with the problem and you keep changing your solutions, you still have scope to pivot and scale. But if you have tried everything, if you've pivoted, like you said, in context, how many times you've pivoted, if you've truly tried all your ideas, if you've used all your brain power, you've talked to everybody possibly, everyone that you could possibly talk to, and you have came to that point where you realize, I don't know, I'm running out of ideas. I don't know what more to do. I don't know what more to do with this app, how many, what kind of more users I can bring in. That's the time that maybe you need to take a jump. That's the time when you need to say, okay, enough with pivoting, let's move on. But in any case, the best part about all these processes, the faster you fail, the faster you realize what's going wrong. Instead of putting in more investments, having more users that are disappointed, excuse me, you need to fail fast. And the moment you see yourself failing, you need to pivot to the next step. Does that make sense to you? All right. Thank you. Thanks for all of you. Any questions, anybody? Which one? No. It's Android and iOS. That was the third version. Actually, when we let me show you a graph, which will, I don't know if you can see it from, can you see some dots there? Yeah? We messed up there on those points, and we have new versions there. Like, it's like almost deleted. The previous one is deleted, and there is a new version. Ideally, it should have been an upgrade. And why we messed up with that was, we had changed platforms on which we built our apps. We couldn't upgrade. So at the end of it, we finally, now the numbers that you are seeing are, this is March, right? So it would be like 12th of March that you would be seeing. We have now, if you put all of them together, 5,100 about from. That, okay. So if anyone here who heard about Think Test that happened last year, November, Anand was speaking there. Yeah, there was a testing conference that we held in Delhi. What happened was, and it's our app only. The reason we are not talking about it is because we actually made it for our use, but we'll see how it goes. For example, all of us are here, but we are not connected socially, right? Now, tomorrow he goes back, he puts loads up some pictures, he uploads pictures, he uploads some experiences. I will never get to see it because I have no idea who he is. I'm not connected to him. So we created Winker, and we had that experience when I was organizing a conference in Delhi, Think Test. So what I did was I would see every random, like third day, some picture shared through X, through Y, to Z, then finally it comes to me. I'm like, oh, okay, this was also clicked, that also happened. Oh, this was happening at this corner. So as an organizer, I was a little, I was disappointed. I really wanted to see all of them. So we created Winker, where anyone can just go and load pictures, and you don't have to really know them socially to see it. But we are, so it's, that's the reason, because it's from the same company, you're seeing it. Oh, I'm glad. Thank you, guys.